mean, I'm satisfied that the initiative has passed some 5 years ago, but I'm not satisfied that there is no application law yet. You know, it's just the Swiss government who has set up a so-called provisional law, but there's no application law yet after 5 years, and that's really bad.
Your initiative was called Against Rip-Off Salaries, Abzocker. What is a rip-off?
To me, rip-off would be more than a million. And but I know that in the banks, higher salaries than
so
that.
More than a million a year.
More than a million a year, you know. But I have a huge problem. Probably I'm not the only one having a huge problem with double-digit salaries. And if a company is run badly, then the shareholders should intervene and should take that sum of compensation down. And if the company is well managed, then maybe a higher sum of compensation is okay.
How come the salaries are that high in the first place?
You know, it went from the banking to the pharma industry and then all the way in the real industry, you know, by Wall Street coming into, by Ospel Wufli coming into Switzerland and then in Basel, Roche, Novartis and so on, and then going into Oerlikon and other industrial companies. You know, that was more way the way over the last 10, 20 years, how the salaries developed, you know. And yeah, nowadays you see high salaries also in real industrial companies.
But the companies, they said, we need to pay these high salaries, otherwise we couldn't get these good guys.
Yeah, that sentence I heard it probably 100 times, you know, and then after a few years they throw it out, you know. You see what happened at Credit Suisse when the new CEO came in. He put all those people on the street. 5,000 to 6,000 people were laid off, you know. So probably the best guys were having a high salary. They get rid of them, you know, something, there's definitely something wrong. And you know, we have a small and medium-sized industry in Switzerland. We earn our money, but we take our risk. And if the company is badly managed or if the company has a loss, then we don't pay any salary at all, you know. And that spirit, because, you know, I'm an entrepreneur from a small, mid-sized company or a little small company. I wanted to have, or I would like to have, that spirit, you know, that entrepreneurial spirit also in the huge blue chip companies, you know.
How come the initiative hasn't been made into a law yet?
Bern is sleeping, you know, definitely.
But who in Bern is sleeping?
The government is sleeping, and you know, there's a whole revision of Aktionärsrecht, you know, and they said, no, we don't want to treat that initiative separately. We want to put it all together in one basket and talk about all the other issues which maybe have to be changed or not, you know. And that was definitely a mistake, you know. If a popular initiative passes in front of the Swiss people, then you should set up a special law for that, you know. And probably if the Swiss people have 18 months to set up a popular initiative, then the government in Bern should also take, or at maximum have 18 months to set up a law.
What is your problem with high salaries? How did it all start?
Probably the best example is UBS, you know, best bank in the world and number one, and, you know, for years and years, and Ospel over 20 million, Wufli over 20 million, and suddenly the government had to help, you know. There's definitely no correlation between high salaries and performance of a company and performance of members of the board or members of the general management.
But still, there have been discussions. It has changed compared to
We have
years.
The discussion for over the last 10, 15 years. We have that discussion. But I really ask that the shareholder, owner of the company, take hard decisions. If the company is badly managed, it doesn't matter if it is the new management or if it is the old management. If you have a loss, especially like Credit Suisse, of a few billions, you know, then there's no money in the pocket, then why shall you pay high salaries?
It's your view on Credit Suisse, so we can't ask him now, but I can't let you go without the last question about your salary.
No, I'm not going to do that because I'm an entrepreneur and take the whole risk of the company, you know. Actually, I'm not taking any salary because I have to have to pay the tax on it. I have to pay the company. I'm the only shareholder, only owner, so I pay the tax on the benefits of my company. I pay the tax on my salary. So probably just leave the money in the company and don't take it out in form of dividend, in terms of salary. So just leave the money run for the company.